Okay, so once there was this old wrinkled jerk named Scrooge who was always like,
"Bah, humbug."
Even during Christmas, he was like,
"Bah, humbug."
So even when everybody was all happy and full of the Christmas spirit and like,
"Merry Christmas,"
he'd still be like,
"Bah, humbug."
So soon enough, the Ghost of Christmas Past shows up and is all like,
"Ooh."
Then the Ghost of Christmas Present shows up and is all like,
"Ooh."
And finally, the Ghost of Christmas Future shows up and is like,
"Hey, I'm the Ghost of Christmas Future. Your dad, Tiny Tim, is dead in the future. Sorry."
So all these time-traveling ghosts make Scrooge realize that he's a jerk. And instead of being like,
"Bah, humbug,"
he should be like,
"Merry Christmas."
So he runs outside and he's like,
"Merry Christmas."
And he sees his nephew and he's like,
"Merry Christmas."
And he sees beggars.
"Merry Christmas."
And dirty orphans.
"Merry Christmas."
Finally, he goes to his assistant Cratchit's house and he's like,
"Bob, I'm afraid I'm gonna have to let you go."
"Just kidding. Merry Christmas!"
And Tiny Tim is like,
"God bless us, everyone."
And everybody's like,
"Aww."
And the angels are like,
"Aww."
And that's pretty much the best Christmas story ever. The end.
May God bless and keep you always. May your wishes all come true. May you always do for others and let others do for you. And may you build a ladder to the stars and climb on every rung. And may you stay forever young. May you stay forever young. May you grow up to be righteous. May you grow up to be true. May you always know the truth and see the light surrounding you. May you always be courageous, stand upright and be strong. And may you stay forever young. And may you stay forever.
This is Christmas Eve, 1970. This is Shane McDonald. I'm going to tell a little story. I'm going to make it up as I go along. Once there lived a little boy. He had a dog. He loved his dog very much. But one day it ran away. He was very sad. He went into the house to tell his mother. His mother was sad too. So after a couple days they waited and then they went out looking for him. And he didn't come back. So his mother and father called some people and see if they saw them. Some. And nobody saw him. So they were very, very sad. The days was passing and they were getting sadder and sadder and sadder. One day, their little dog came home. They were very happy. So, every time when that little boy was playing with his dog outside, he made sure that he wouldn't run away. And wouldn't get run over by a car. And so he was very, very happy. He told his mother and father that his dog came back. They were very, very happy too. So they called all the other people and all their friends, and all their friends and all the people, and they told them that they got their dog back. And he was very, very happy, and he was very, very, very proud of his dog that he came back. So he lived happily ever after.
Now, whose dog is that story about? Is that about our own little dog?
Yeah.
What's our dog's name?
Bonnie.
Yeah. That story is about our own little dog, isn't it?
Yeah.
What?
Who's the boy?
Me.
And you're the boy that's involved, are you?
Yeah.
Okay. Were you very happy to have your dog back?
Yeah.
Were you?
No, it's true, too.
And that's a true story, yeah. Story to tell?
Mm-hmm.
You tell your story then, eh?
Once upon a time, there lived a boy named David.
Huh?
And he had a little kitten. He played with his kitten.
Huh?
Once upon a time, when he put him outside with no leash, the kitten ran away. When the boy went out, and so he's so sad. So he called other, he's all these prisoners, and when he comes all over, when he heard on the radio said. The end of the dog is a kitten name, banana. And so we looked for his dog, and the dog was, he found him. So he called out his name. And when he wake up in the morning, he saw the kitten down in the basement. So I went down there and put the kitten in his bed. And so I went outside and played with him. And so I put all the Christmas all over his Christmas tree.
and they live happily after ever.
That's a wonderful story, David. That's just a wonderful story.
There was a boy named... There was a boy named David, and there's a boy named...
I don't know. Who is... What? How old is David?
David is four.
He's four, is he? And is he a bad little boy or a good little boy?
He's a real good boy.
Oh, he is he?
And his dog is, and his kitten, so he's so good, too.
Oh, that's good. That's great. Well, Santa Claus should be good to you tonight, since you're such a good boy, eh?
Yeah.
Yeah, he should be very good.
Because I told him you a story.
Yes, that's right. Well, okay, then. Well, that's the end of your story, eh?
Hey,
okay,
you...
Vernon.
Donkey. But
'Twas the night before Christmas when all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. Stockings were hung by a chimney with care, in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. The children were nestled all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. And Mama in a kerchief and I in my cap had just sold our brains for a long winter snap. When out on the lawn there rose such a cloud, I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. Away to the window I flew like a flash, to open shutters and to up sash. The new brain snow of the gave laughter of midday to all these below. In what room I wondering eyes did appear by a miniature sleigh, an eight-time ranger. With a little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment must be St. Nick. More rapid than eagles, the closest they came, and wishes on children and called them by name. Now prancing, now dancing, now common, now dancing, and vixen, on Cupid, on Donner, to top of the porch, to top of the wall, now dash away all. that's all.
And they heard him exclaim when he went out of sight.
And they heard him exclaim when he rolled out of sight, "Happy Christmas to all, and to all good night."
That's real good, Paul. That's just beautiful.
Can I sing Santa Claus Coming to Town?
Okay, just a sec. So what did you want to do now, Paul?
Santa Claus is coming to town.
Okay, go on then.
You better watch out, you better not cry, you better not pout, I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town, he's making a list and checking it twice. Gonna find out who's naughty or nice, Santa Claus is coming to town. He sees you when you're sleeping, he knows when you're awake. He knows if you've been bad or good, so be good for goodness sakes. Oh, you better watch out. You better not cry. You better not pout. I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town.
That's just a dandy song. I don't hear too much applause, though, from the audience here.
Okay. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay, that's enough now. Don't overdo it. How about you? Going to be before you say it.
What?
I don't trust you sometimes.
It's just going to be one thing that we got from Christmas.
Okay.
It's an electric train.
Oh, yeah. We almost forgot about that. That's going to be really something when I get it set up, eh? Yeah. Okay. How about you, Shane? I don't think you've done too much talking, did you yet?
No.
Okay. Come on over here, then.
Shane.
What do you want to say now?
Well, I like tonight. I just had nice fun talking with everybody.
Tonight, did you?
Yeah.
You really enjoyed that, honey?
Yeah.
You're getting quite a bit older now, aren't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, you really enjoyed it.
Yes, me and Mom are going to sing Silver Bells.
Well, that's going to be something great.
It's my first year, so...
You have to speak up, Mother.
This is my first year to record with the children, so Shane and I are going to sing Silver Bells.
That's going to be a real sad affair. Okay, then. I'll plug my ears. Okay, there you go.
City sidewalks, busy sidewalks, dressed in holiday style. In the air there's a feeling of Christmas. Children laughing, people passing,
meeting smile after smile. And on every street corner you hear, silver bells, silver bells. It's Christmas time in the city. Ring-a-ling, hear them ring. Soon it will be Christmas Day. Strings of street lights, even stoplights, blink a bright red and green as the shoppers rush home with their treasures. Hear the snow crunch, see the kids punch. This is Santa's big scene. And above all this bustle you hear, silver bells, silver bells. It's Christmas time in the city. Ring-a-ling, hear them ring. Soon it will be Christmas Day.
I told you that was going to be a sad song. I just want to say one thing before the tape runs out. Thank God that we're all here this year, happy, healthy. And I hope we'll all be here together next year.
I hope we are too.
Yeah, we're awful glad to have our...